first for Men and then for Dean Giocnor. You said at the outset of your presentation, Men, that you hope that lessons from the excise tax battle might be useful as you are now pushing for the comprehensive tax reform. I wonder if you could highlight a bit some of the similarities and contrasts between those two, particularly how excise tax, first of all, did not require any major new level of bureaucratic capacity in order to implement that law, whereas the comprehensive tax reform, and particularly the whole regime of subsidies, does require major new levels of bureaucratic capacity. So just to reflect on that a bit. Secondly, Dean Giocnor, I wanted to get your thoughts on a comment I heard a year ago. I was on a panel with Christian Monsoy on the topic of federalism. For those of you who don't know, former member of the 1986 Constitutional Commission. Attorney Monsoy said at that point that he was worried that the whole push for constitutional revision in the Philippines currently might be seen as a Trojan horse, a way in which the real goal for some, not for all, but for some might be to put new authoritarian provisions into the Constitution. So I wanted to get your thoughts on that Trojan horse thesis, and particularly relevant might be the draft of a new constitution that was recently put forth by PGP Laban. And in the section on human rights, pertaining to the Commission on Human Rights, it specifically says that the CHR, under a new constitution, if that were to go through, should be responsible for human rights abuses, not only of the government, but also of any other actors in society. Thank you.